रिमेनिंग मेंबर व्हाट यू डू, दिस इज योर गन डायोड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स. ओके, इन दिस इसमें की तरह सीइंग यू आर हैविंग द गन पावर सप्लाई. ओके, दिस इज योर माइक्रोवेव टेस्ट बेंच. ओके, सो माइक्रोवेव टेस्ट बेंच सेटअप, हियर यू आर हैविंग द गन पावर सप्लाई, हियर यू आर हैविंग द गन डायोड. सो गन सप्लाई यू आर कनेक्टेड टू हियर गन सप्लाई. यू आर हैविंग अ पिन मॉड्यूलेटर, सो आफ्टर गन डायोड यू आर हैविंग द पिन मॉड्यूलेटर. दिस पिन मॉड्यूलेटर इट इज कनेक्टेड टू योर पिन सप्लाई. इफ यू आर सीइंग योर रिफ्लेक्स क्लेस्ट्रॉन ऑसिलेटर, देयर यू आर हैविंग द एनोड वोल्टेज एंड रिपेलर वोल्टेज. हियर यू आर हैविंग गन पावर सप्लाई एंड पिन सप्लाई. सो गन पावर सप्लाई एंड पिन सप्लाई दिस टू कंबाइंडली दे आर जनरेटिंग द ऑसिलेशन. ओके, सो आफ्टर दिस यू आर हैविंग दिस आइसोलेटर. Okay, so what is the property of isolator? Isolator, it will allow all the signal in one direction. Okay, so whatever the signal is generated, all the signal will pass through it. Okay, and there will be no back signal. There will be no any back signal. So whatever the signal is generated, all the signal it is passing through it. Okay, in one direction only. Only in one direction. That is actually the property of your isolator. And because of that, we have used this isolator. After that, you are having this variable attenuator. Okay, variable attenuator. If you are seeing, if you are making it completely open, so here you are having the minimum attenuation. Okay, so attenuation you can consider it as the resistance at lower frequency. Okay, so what if we are having minimum attenuation means it will allow all the signal to pass through it. Okay, and if you are providing some attenuation, it will resist the flow of microwave frequency signal. Okay, so in order to allow all the signal, we will just keep it open. Okay, so whatever the signal is there, whatever signal is generated, it is totally passing through your isolator, and we are not providing any attenuation. We are not providing any attenuation, and that output we can go and we can see it in your VSWR meter, voltage standing wave ratio meter. Okay, so at present, whenever we are going for seeing the gun diode characteristics, during that time, this is actually not required. So gun diode characteristics means just we are going for seeing the voltage and current characteristics. Okay, so there you are having voltage and current. So what will So, we'll make a graph between voltage and current. Okay. So, this is your voltage and this is your current. Now, we note down say 5 to 10 readings. Okay, we'll note down 5 to 10 readings and we'll see that as you are increasing the voltage, what is the change in current? Okay. Here, actually, if you are going for seeing the gun diode characteristics, it will be something like this. That whenever you are increasing the voltage, the current will increase. It will increase up to a certain level. And after that, whenever you are increasing the voltage, the current will start decreasing. Okay. So you have to catch this point. You have to catch this point. Means the voltage where you are having maximum current. This voltage is called your threshold voltage. Okay, this voltage is your threshold voltage. We are making a tabular column of voltage and current. Okay, we note down 5 to 10 readings of voltages and so you can take in the terms of some steps you can take. Increase, go on increasing it, go on increasing it. Yeah, see what had happened?
From this side.
So you just go on increasing it. Go on increasing it. So when you are increasing the voltage, current is also increasing. Go on increasing it.
Decreasing.
Now what is happening?
Decreasing.
So you have to catch a point where you are having the maximum current. Just do that one.
Back.
Where you are having the maximum current? The place where you are having
0.161.
okay, this is your ampere, this is your ampere. Okay, so current, this much current you are getting, and this is the voltage where you are getting this seat. Okay, so this is the maximum current. So we can say that this is your threshold voltage. Now just take 2 or 3 readings before that and 2 or 3 readings after 0.57. during that time your current is 0.098. go for one more reading. When you are going for your 2.71, your current is 0.144. and after that we have seen this, you go little bit more than this, you are going for 4.46, then your current is 0.153. go for one more. Say if you are going for 8.48, here you are getting 0.127. so in this way you can note down 5 to 10 readings where you are getting the maximum current. Okay, so from these two values you have to make a graph. Your graph will be something like this. Okay.